exercise 20, question number 22. See here, I will read the question first. A sum of rupees 2000 was borrowed at 8% per annum. A sum of rupees 2000 was borrowed at 8% per annum. After 6 months, it was repaid with interest. What was the amount paid? Means we have to find here amount, how much amount is paid. Okay, so first what we'll do, we'll write here what is given. See, question number 22. See, in this first what it is given? Sum of amount rupees 2000. So principal is given rupees 2000. Okay, so P is equal to rupees 2000 was borrowed at 8% per annum. So what is given rate? Rate how much it is given? 8% per annum. 8% per annum. Okay, after 6 months it was repaid. After 6 months, so period is how much given? 6 months. Period is not given in year. See, period is given in months. So we need to convert these 6 months into year. Okay. And after that, what it is asked? It was repaid with interest. What was the amount paid? So what we have to find? We have to find how much amount is paid. Okay. So amount is equal to how much? Okay. So now what I said here, principal is given, rate of interest is given, 8% per annum it is given. And we have to find now, see, 6 months, period is given 6 months. It is given in months, so we have to convert into year. So 6 months, 6 months means how much it is year? 6 months means half year, you know, 6 months. Whole year, 12 months. In a year, how many months are there? 12 months. Means 12 months is equal to 1 year. Then 6 months is equal to how much? Half year. See, so for 6 months, we will divide by 12. See, for 6 months, we will divide by 12. Okay. So, if we will divide by 12 for 6 months, then we will get year, half year. 6 ones are 6, 6 twos are 12. So, 1 upon 2. Half year we got. How much year we got? Half year. Now half year. See, to get, make it easy calculation, what I will do, this half year I will convert into decimal. See, for 1 we will divide by 2. So it make easy while doing the calculation. Okay. For half year what we have to do? See, 1 upon 2. 1 upon 2 means for 1 we have to divide by 2. Okay, so 2 zeros are 0. Okay, so 2 zeros are 0. 1 minus 0, 1. 1 minus 0, 1. Now what we do? Here give the decimal point. Here also give decimal point. When we give here at the same time, we have to give the decimal point here also. Okay, now write 0, own 0. Okay, and take this 0 down. 2 fives are 10. 2 5s are 10. 0 minus 0, 0. 1 minus 1, 0. So 0.5. So what we got, half year means 0.5. Okay. What we got, half year means 0.5 yearly. Okay. See, this period is given in month. So we need to convert into year. So what we did, we convert in year. So for that, we divide by 12. We divide by 12 for these 6 months. Okay. So, if we divide by 12, what we got? Half. Half we got. See, 6 ones are 6, 6 twos are 12. Half year we got. So, to make it easy calculation, what we did? We divide for 1 by 2. So, what we got? 0.5 year. Okay. So, what we got? 0.5 year. Okay. Means this 1 upon 2 we convert into decimal. Okay, this fraction we convert into decimal. So what we got? 0.5 year. Okay, so now let's solve this example. See, here I am writing this for 6 months we have done here. Okay, calculation for 6 months, convert 6 months into year. We have done this calculation. Now our example I will show this side. Okay, now principal. principal is rupees 2000. So we have to find first interest. To find amount, first we should know the interest. What is the formula for amount? Amount is equal to principal plus interest. So we should know first interest. So find interest first. Interest is equal to P multiplied by N multiplied by R. Okay. Divided by 100. Okay. Now what is principal? 2000 rupees. Okay. 2000. N means C. What we got N? See here. And we got 0.5. See, and we got 0.5 here. So here write 0.5. To make it easy calculation, if I will take here 1 upon 2 and again divided by 100, it will be difficult for you to understand. So I convert this fraction into decimal. Okay. So 0.5 multiplied by R. Rate of interest is 8. Okay. Upon 100. So now solve this. Upper 0, downside 0 get cancelled. Upper 0, downside 0 get cancelled. Now what remain here? 20 multiplied by 0.5 multiplied by 8. Now 20 multiplied by 0.5 we will do first. See here I will show the rough work. 20 multiplied by 0.5 we have to do. Okay, now without thinking for this decimal point, first do the calculation and then shift the decimal point. Okay, so 5 zeros are 0, 5 twos are 10. Okay, so what we got here? 100 we got. If you will multiply by 0 for this 0, you are going to get here 0 only, for this also 0. So again you are going to get here 0. So at that sum you are going to get 100. Okay, so now shift this decimal point. See, after decimal point here 1 digit. So for answer, before one digit, give the decimal point. Okay, see. Okay, so where it will come? 10.0. So what it will come? 10.0. Why I gave the decimal point here, understood? See here, 0.5. See, after decimal point here, one digit. So before one digit, give the decimal point. Okay, so 10.0. So what is the answer? For 20.05, 10 is the answer. Okay. Or you can do by this way also. 0.5 multiplied by 20. This is also correct way to solve. You can solve by any way. 0.5s are 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 plus. Now here we will write 0. 2.5s are 10. 1 is carried. 2 zeros are 0 and 1. 2 zeros are 0. 0 plus 1, 1. 0 plus 0, 0. 0 plus 0, 0. So 1 will come here. Now see here, after decimal point here, 1 digit. So for answer give before 1 digit decimal point. See, count the digit from right towards left. So what we got answer? 10. So we got answer 10. Anyway you can solve this. Okay. Do the calculation anyway. But give the decimal point with correct way. Okay. So 20 multiplied by 0.5, what we got? What we got? 10. Multiple by 8. So what we got now here? 10 into 8. 10 multiplied by 8. What we got? 80. Okay. So interest, how much we got? Interest we got 80. Interest we got 80. Rupees 80. Now we have to find the amount. So for what is the formula for to find the amount? Amount is equal to principal plus interest. So principal how much it is? Rupees 2000. And interest how much it is? Rupees 80. So what is the answer? 0 plus 0, 0. 0 plus 8, 8. Here there is no number. So write this 0 as it is. Here at 1000 plus also there is no number. So write this 2 as it is. So what we got amount? Rupees 2080. And what it is asked in the question? What was the amount paid? So amount paid rupees 2080. Okay. Let's solve question number 23. Rupees 500 at 6% per annum for 2 years. And rupees 400 at 5% per annum for 3 years. Where borrowed means, see, 2 times it is borrowed. But different time, different principal and different rate of interest are given. Okay. Find the difference between the amounts after the expiry of the respective period. So let's write here first what is given. See, first one, principal is rupees 500. Okay. Then in rate how much it is given? Rate is given 6% per annum. Okay, 6% per annum. And N means period. Period how much it is given? 2 years. Okay, 2 years. And after that what it is given? See, here I will write that things. After that, and rupees 400 means for this what is the principal? Rupees 400. Okay, then rate how much? 5% per annum. What is given rate? Rate is given 5% per annum. Okay, and after that 3 years were borrowed. This period is given 3 years. This N is equal to 3 years. Okay, 3 years. Okay, so let's find first amount paid for this. So to find the amount, first we should know the interest. To find the amount, first we should know the interest. Okay, so first let's find the interest. So interest is equal to P multiplied by N multiplied by R upon 100. Okay, so principal is rupees 500. N, how much time it is? 2 years. Period is 2 years. And rate 6%. Okay, 6% upon 100. Okay, so now let's calculate this. Upper 0, downside 0 get cancelled. Upper 0, downside 0 get cancelled. Now write this. 5 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 6 is equal to 5 2s are 10, 10 6 are 60. So what we got interest? Interest we got 60 rupees. Interest how much we got? 60 rupees. Now what we have to find? Amount. Amount is equal to principal plus interest. Now what is the principal in this? Rupees 500. And what is the interest? Interest is rupees 60. Okay, so add this 0 plus 0, 0, 0 plus 6, 6, and here 5. So rupees 560. So how much amount we got here? 560. Now let's find the amount for these also. So now what is the principal here? Rupees 400. So find the interest first. Interest is equal to principal multiplied by N multiplied by R. Okay. P into N into R upon 100. Okay. Now how much it is? Principal is 400 rupees. N, period is 3 years. And rate of interest it is given 5% per annum. Okay. So 5 upon 100. Okay. See here, period is different, rate of interest is different and principal is different. So for this we find the different. And here also principal different, rate of interest different and period is different. So we have to find the interest for these also differently and amount also. Okay. So now calculate this. Upper 0, downside 0 get cancelled. Upper 0, downside 0 get cancelled. So 4 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 5. So 4 3s are 12 and 12 5s are 60. So how much we got interest here? Interest we got 60 rupees. Okay. Interest we got 60. Then let's find the amount. Okay. So amount is equal to, so amount is equal to principal plus interest. So what is principal here? Rupees 400. Okay. Principal is rupees 400 plus interest. Interest is rupees 60. See here. 0 plus 0, 0. 0 plus 6, 6. What we got here? 460. Okay. 460. Amount what we got here? Amount we got 460. So for this we got amount 560. For this we got amount 460. Now what it is asked? Find the difference between the amounts. Find the difference between the amounts after expiry of respective period. So now what we have to do? We have to find the difference between all these amounts. See what it is asked? Find the difference between the amounts. So right here, see I don't have place, I am writing here. Difference difference between the amounts. Difference between the amounts is equal. So I don't have place on writing here. Rupees 560 minus rupees 460. We have to find the difference between of these amounts, na? See, find the difference between of the amounts. Difference between the amounts. So 0 minus 0, 0. 6 minus 6, 0. 5 minus 4, 1. Okay. So rupees 100. So what we got difference between the amounts? Rupees 100. What is the difference between the amounts? Rupees 100.